One, two, three, four, five, it makes me feel alive. Six, seven, I ate it.
Yummy, yummy, in my tummy. One, two, three, four, give me more and give me more.
Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you. In that stew, before it's through, you'll learn of veggies and what they do. Healthy foods grow from the ground. They grow from all around, around. Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you. That's what we'll do, we'll make it just for you and you.
Yummy, yummy, in my tummy. One, two, three, four, give me more and give me more.
Planted by people on farms big and small. Enjoyed by people small and tall. Planted by people on farms big and small. Enjoyed by people small and tall. Harvest you, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you. In that stew, before it's through, you'll learn of veggies and what they do. Healthy foods grow from the ground. They grow from all around, around. Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you. This will be your harvest stew, way long overdue. Just hang around a little while, I guarantee I'll make you smile. This will be your harvest stew, way long overdue. Just hang around a little while, I guarantee I'll make you smile. This will be your harvest stew, way long overdue. Just hang around a little while, I guarantee I'll make you smile.
Make you smile, make you smile. Yummy, yummy, in my tummy. One, two, three, four, give me more and give me more.
Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you. In that stew, before it's through, you'll learn of veggies and what they do. Healthy foods grow from the ground. They grow from all around, around. Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you. Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you.
Yummy, yummy, in my tummy. One, two, three, four, give me more and give me more.
Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you. In that stew, before it's through, you'll learn of veggies and what they do. Healthy foods grow from the ground. They grow from all around, around. Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you. Harvest stew, that's what we'll do. We'll make it just for you and you.
Hey, hello, Mr. Pickles. Hello, Mr. Pickles. Are you going to help me out now? Here we go.
Sing along with Mr. Pickles.
Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds.
Victoria and her brothers Ferris, Cameron, and Sawyer had a plan. Raise your hand if you have ever had a plan. Their plan was to spend an entire day outside exploring and running, walking and playing in their neighborhood, which just happened to be the beautiful rolling farmlands right here in your town, Wisconsin. It was a perfect day, not too hot, not too cold. The weather was cooperating with their big plans. They wouldn't, they couldn't, and didn't think about anything else but all that fun and exploration they were going to have. They were really excited, but they forgot to do one very important thing before they left for their day of fun. Do you know what they forgot?
Mr. Pickles, now what did they forget?
They forgot to eat a healthy breakfast that morning. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Raise your hand if you had breakfast today.
Mr. Pickles, I had breakfast.
Mr. Pickles sure did. That's why I have power. Show me the power and muscles in your arms. After a long play day of fun and exploration, Victoria and her brothers Ferris, Cameron, and Sawyer started to head home. But now they were very hungry and very tired. They remembered that they forgot to eat breakfast. They could hardly wait to get home for dinner. We all know how important good, healthy food is to build strong bodies and strong minds. But hungry tummies can't build strong bodies, and hungry tummies can't build strong minds.
Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds.
Well, on the way home, they came upon Farmer Frank. He had a wagon full of wonderful, colorful garden vegetables.
Carrots, carrots, cabbage, cabbage, onions, onions, celery, celery, pea pods, corn, corn, tomatoes, tomatoes, parsnips, parsnips, asparagus, asparagus, broccoli. Broccoli. Veggies make a difference in my life. Veggies make a difference to me. Veggies make a difference in my life. Veggies make a difference to me. Veggies make a difference in my life. Veggies make a difference to me. Veggies make a difference in my life. Veggies make a difference to me.
Wait, just one moment. Mr. Pickles forgot something. One very important ingredient.
Mr. Pickles, what did you forget?
I forgot the potatoes.
Mr. Pickles, please add the potatoes.
Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds.
Well, now they asked Farmer Frank, could you share or spare a couple bites of food for our very hungry tummies and tired bodies to build our strong minds? Farmer Frank said, I would love to be able to help, but I need to sell this food to be able to buy shoes for my children. Well, the four of them understood how important shoes were because they needed their shoes to play in all day to protect their feet.
Sing along, Mr. Pickles!
Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds.
Well, as they continued on their journey, they came upon Loretta the lady standing outside her home, and they asked her, could you share or spare a couple bites of food for our very hungry tummies and tired bodies to build our strong minds? Well, Loretta said, I would love to be able to help, but I just gave the little extra food I had to our neighbors. All four of them understood how important it was to be a good neighbor. so they were glad to see her help her neighbors when they needed it as well.
Mr. Pickles, I'm a good neighbor.
Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds.
Further down the road, Victoria, Ferris, Cameron, and Sawyer stopped at the home of Melissa the mom and David the dad. They were sitting on their front porch and they asked, could you share or spare a couple bites of food for our very hungry tummies and tired bodies to build our strong minds? We would love to help, but we have to keep all our food because we have 8 kids in our family. Well, all 4 of them also understood how important it was to share and cooperate because they were also members of a very big family.
Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies.
Well, they knew they couldn't play well if they were hungry or tired. The body just won't operate or cooperate without good, healthy food and rest. It just wouldn't be, it just couldn't be any fun. Well, at this point, they formed a circle of cooperation, put their thinking caps on, and like magicians, rubbed their hands together and started coming up with a plan. And oh, what a plan!
Sing along with Mr. Pickles!
Veggies make a difference in my life. Veggies make a difference to me. Veggies make a difference in my life. Veggies make a difference to me. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Veggies make a difference in my life. Veggies make a difference to me. Veggies make a difference in my life. Veggies make a difference to me. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong bodies. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds. Hungry tummies can't build strong minds.
Abracadabra! Here we go! Ready to sing along? Here we go!
Abracadabra.
This year is made for you!
Abracadabra!
If everyone helps and gives just a little, something big can be the result. A lot of great helpers just like you can make all the dreams in the world come true. More than just food will be at this table. Good old-fashioned know-how using magic of team effort, magic of cooperation, magic of imagination, magic of hard work, magic of
wonderful and ingredients.
Abracadab, abracadab, abracadab.
This stew is made for you.
Abracadab.
For starters, they gathered up everyone and said, "We are magicians of goodwill, working together to make enough food by creating a magical harvest stew, by creating a magical harvest stew for you and you and you and you and you."
First, they needed a huge pot filled with water and a fire underneath. Before you could count to three, a gigantic one appeared. People brought buckets of water and wagons of logs, delivered by the strong hands of everyone. It was an incredible sight.
Farmer Frank said, "I have some carrots and purple cabbage too. They didn't sell at the market. I really won't miss them for the magical harvest stew." Loretta, the lady who gave to her neighbors, she wanted to help her friends. So she gave potatoes, some great big potatoes, to the magical harvest stew. Melissa, the mom, and David, the dad, after sitting on their front porch, realized that they could share and spare for the magical harvest stew.
And so it went all day long. Family after family, friend after friend, and neighbor after neighbor continued to stop by the magical harvest stew to add their personal ingredients. Onions and beef, celery, peas, tomatoes and corn, parsnips and broccoli, asparagus and barley. And for seasoning, salt, pepper, dill, parsley, and some chives. All mixed in with a whole lot of love and became the perfect recipe for the magical harvest stew.
Well, enough tables for the entire town were gathered and set in the square for a feast to be remembered for all time.
Abracadab, abracadab, abracadabra.
This stew is made for you.
Abracadabra.
Well, Victoria, Ferris, Sawyer, and Cameron had been on their way home from a very long day of playing outside. All four of them had forgotten to eat breakfast that morning, but they filled up on cooperation and very healthy food that was grown from the ground up just like you. When we all cook and create together, the magic of cooperation will fill our very hungry tummies and tired bodies forever.
Abracadabra.
Abracadabra.
This stew is made for you.
Abracadabra.